Now, when we talk about being reconciled to your past, there's an image, an icon, that people have found power in for thousands of years. I'm talking about the cross. We see crosses all the time. People of all different perspectives and backgrounds and nationalities and religious beliefs use crosses. Does it ever strike you as strange that a cross is an ancient execution device? So why has this particular execution device endured as an image and an icon of hope for people? Well, the cross is about Jesus, who was killed on one. The worst possible thing that could happen to a human being happened, and that wasn't the end of the story. What I find really compelling is that in the New Testament, there is this line about how the cross is God reconciling all things. God wants you to be whole. So how do you make peace with your past? First, you gotta name it in all its mess. You have to give it language, because until you can say, this is what happened to me, it's still in there somewhere. As you begin to own your story, what it does is it raises your awareness. It heightens your senses to others who are going through what you've been through. You can actually look them in the eyes and say, me too. Your pain becomes their hope. Your suffering becomes their healing. This is the mystery at the heart of the reconciliation of all things. The death on a cross becomes the exact channel through which God's love flows to everyone.
It was incredible. I feel like I learned so much, and it's been, you know, several weeks since the tour ended, and I'm still probably like you, thinking about things I heard, reflecting on it. I'm like still sort of inhaling the fumes of all that positive energy and wisdom. It's incredible, life-changing.
If you don't have a lot of time to shop for a gift for that special person in your life, we can help. Today, gift guru Sandra Mag Salmon will show us a few creative gifts when time is of the essence.